Welcome back to our SAP enablement series. In addition to our basic course about the SAP SQL connector, I want to share some best practices how to optimize data queries and load procedures. The topics that I want to bring you closer are text mapping, subselect, connection tweaks, and hierarchy load. Let's start with text mapping. As you certainly know, fields in SAP transform tables have standardized but quite technical names. An experienced SAP business user could be fine with having these field definitions in a Qlik dashboard. But wouldn't it be beneficial to have a more meaningful field description? Especially because SAP provides the information in a helpful view of their data dictionary. Why not using this content to rename the default fields and provide them in a Qlik data model? I have prepared a demo how to achieve this. In the load script of an example app, I have created different sections. In SQL query, I load four tables in order to be able to analyze sales order in relation to customer material master data. As you can see, all tables provide the default cryptical field names. Above the script part, I have put a section called Text Description from DD, where I load all fields and text descriptions from the view DD03M with regards to all the transparent tables required for my sales analysis into an auxiliary table called SourceMap. In order to replace the technical field names by their text description, I just have to add one line of code at the end of my script in a dedicated section called Rename Fields. Voila! Now execute the load script and see the magic happen. After the load has been completed, we jump directly to the data model viewer and see the data model with all the relevant tables for my sales analysis now containing user-friendly names. This could be helpful, right? Okay, what else could I show you with the SQL connector? SQL subselects could be another good example of our best practices. Okay, what do I mean by subselect? Well, it is a SQL query within another SQL query. When is it a significant use case in terms of SAP integration into Qlik? When you want to speed up your load performance and when you want to filter data records by values which don't exist in your primary source table. Let's assume you want to analyze the table BSEG, providing a huge amount of accounting documents. A very wide and deep table with probably hundreds of fields and millions of records. In my use case, it has more than 300 columns and 1.3 million rows. Loading the complete dataset into Qlik Sense will not make sense in most cases and will last exceptionally long. Of course, we can query the table with where conditions to minimize loading times. But what if a suitable filter cannot be applied? For example, monthly base queries are not feasible because the required date field does not exist in BSEG, but in BKPF. This table contains accounting document header data, including booking dates, and it is linked to BSEG, inter alia via the field BELNR. So why not requesting all accounting document numbers of a month, January 2008 for instance, from BKPF at first, and pass this result to a subsequent query against BSEG to fetch all records according to the identified accounting document numbers. This procedure would fulfill my requirements with an acceptable and efficient loading time. Let's see how to implement this idea in Qlik. In an example script, I have added a standard load statement for BSEG with an extract of four fields. Now I just have to extend the statement with a nested where clause. The select statement in brackets is executed first, querying all document numbers from January 1st to January 31st in 2008 in BKPF and passes the result to the initial select statement of BSEG. Executing this, I receive 190,000 records in seconds due to the facts that I just focused on a small number of fields of BSEG. The nested SQL statement is fully executed on SAP DB site, and I limited the amount of records due to the date filter of January 2008. So, with subselects, you have the possibility to filter your data based on references of adjunctant tables, an efficient and fast way to load required data for your analysis. The next advice I want to share with you are system performance and data cleansing tweaks. Having a more detailed view at the settings of a SAP SQL data connection in a Qlik load script, you can optionally define connection string properties. For instance, you can change the buffer percentage, which defines the amount of free shared memory buffer that can be used by the corresponding SAP task executing the Qlik load statement. Be aware that a higher value increases the speed, but also increases the risk of conflicts with other SAP tasks. Another example is the parameter remove all blanks. If set to on, it takes care to trim fields containing only blank characters. It leaves one blank in order to differentiate from null fields. More details with regards to the extended settings can be found on our site help.qlik.com when searching for SAP connector clients in the help section Qlik connectors. Let's move on to another important topic customer often asked for, whether and how SAP hierarchies can be taken over to Qlik. Nothing easier than that. There are even two options available, using the SAP extractor or SQL connector. Let's take a look at the differences. The extractor connector offers a wizard to choose and load hierarchies. In order to discover and fetch data, a logical system with change permissions needs to be created in SAP ERP beforehand. This additional step requires extended authorizations in the SAP UI. The SAP basis team has to apply first. The loading script generated by the wizard does not contain any assignment of text descriptions. If necessary, these must be supplemented by a manual script extension. So, the extractor connector is a valuable but not the best approach getting your SAP hierarchies into Qlik. How does the SQL connector perform instead? It is using a generic script we have developed. The only thing you need to do here, besides copying the script into a Qlik Sense app, is inserting the SAP hierarchy name and press reload. In five steps, all data extraction, text mappings, and the hierarchy composition take place, providing you with a multi-layer dataset you can then visualize with a pivot table, for instance. Because of its ease of use and functionality, this generic script is our preferred way to hand over SAP hierarchies to Qlik. Let me show you how simple it is. In my prepared app, you find the relevant script. We, of course, are happy to share with you. Just follow the link below the video. As already mentioned, the script performs five tasks. But at first, you need to provide a hierarchy name you want to refer to. In my case, I'm interested in the plant hierarchy. So I paste this definition in line 6, which will fill a variable. Optionally, you can change the data connection for caching data as QVD or specify another language. That's it. With these parameters, the script is ready to run. In the first step, it will extract metadata for the defined hierarchy, which is required in the second step to load all nodes and leaves. As we get only IDs at this stage, step 3 picks all corresponding text fields. Step 4 joins all tables together, before in step 5 the hierarchy creation happens. Let's have a look at the result. In the data model viewer, we can determine that for each hierarchy level, we got a txtsh field listing the relevant text description of the nodes and leaves, while the field hierarchy delivers a string with the complete tree structure of each record. Jumping to an example sheet shows how data can be displayed, for instance, as filter panes, pivot table, or bar chart. As you could see, integration of SAP hierarchies is not a big challenge, but a lightweight process. Try it out. This concludes my best practices in terms of Qlik's SAP SQL connector. I hope you find it helpful, and I wish you much success with the implementation of your SAP integration in Qlik. See you again in one of our further learning videos of our SAP enablement series. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.